Sabakus Serverbot, Arto-translate. Good morning, everyone! Welcome to the chaotic and a complicated city, where wonders the charity and street Asia's destinations. Welcome to the country of the New Delhi. My name is Glynis Pitogo, or you can call me Glenn or Ati Nis, and I will be your tour guide for 4 days and 3 nights. In behalf of Travel on Tours, I'd like to welcome you all, and while we are heading to our destinations, I'd like to take a minute to familiarize you with the area and discuss some safety precautions. First, I ask you that remain seated until we reach our destinations. Second, always follow the itinerary that is given to you and always stay within that group. Third, never leave your things unattended to avoid unnecessary loss. And lastly, don't forget to our bus number 107. And now, I give you some details about the New Delhi country. New Delhi, national capital of India. It is situated in the north central part of the country, on the west bank of the Yamuna River, adjacent to and adjacent south of Delhi city. All Delhi and within the Delhi national capital territory. Welcome to our first destination, the Red Fort. The impressive main entrance, the Lahore Gate, is so named as it faces towards Lahore in Pakistan, while the even grander Delhi Gate was used by the Imperial for ceremonial processions. Entering through the Lahore Gate, visitors reach Chatat Chowk, a 17th century covered bazaar where items such as silk, jewelry, gems, and silverware can be purchased, along with the souvenirs and food items. The Nowbat Khan within the Red Fort once houses the musicians who played for the Imperial, and its fine galleries still contain many interesting musicals instruments such as kettle drums, gongs and cymbals, Diwang Ayam, the whole of public audiences, where the Emperor would receive his subjects, is also worth seeing for its stunning white marbles. Welcome to our second destination, the Lodi Garden. One of the most popular among locals in the New Delhi is the 90-acre Lodi Garden. It's a well worth including on your Delhi itinerary. In addition to its lush gardens, the park contains numerous relics from the Lodi period pre-1600s, including a variety of important tombs and ruins. Architectural highlights including the 15th century mausoleums containing the remains of the Lodi sultans, as well as a picturesque triple dome mosque, the glazed dome known for its blue tiles, and the ruin of a huge dome dating from around 1490. Be sure to also look for the At Pola, an 8-pier bridge dating from the 16th century with its attractive column and arcs that span the park's lake. Now, we are here in the third destination, the Lotus Temple. The magnificent Bahas House of Worship, also known as the Lotus Temple due to its nine side and stunning central dome, is an architectural masterpiece, constructions of white concrete and marble. The entire structures look as delicate as the flower it resembles. Rising from the surrounding nine pools of water, it almost appears as it might burst into bloom at any moment. Built in 1986, the temple has since attracted more than 70 million visitors, making it one of the world's most visited attractions. Interestingly, this remarkable place of worship has no idols, religious pictures, or outward symbols of religions. And now we are in the fourth destination. Welcome to the Purana Kela. Although often overlooked, as most tourists head straight for the more famous Red Fort, Purana Kela or Old Fort is a well worth squeezing into your Delhi travel itinerary, boasting a past that stretches back some 2,500 years. Much of the current impressive edificate dates back to the 1500s, although evidence of earlier structures dating back to the 3rd century have been discovered. The present structures played an important role in the regions, appears for centuries, and was particularly influenced by the Muslim religion, as evidenced by buildings such as the Qila Ikona Mosque, a single dome place of worship built in 1541. Now we are in the second days of itinerary. Welcome to our first destinations, the National Zoological Park. Reported to be one of the best zoos in Asia, the National Zoological Park was established in 1959 and provides a habitat to some 1,500 animals and bird species. The abundant wildlife on display are representative of all continents, including numerous examples from Africa, Australia, and Asia. Of particular note are the zoo's numerous chimpanzee, along with the hippopotamus, spiders, monkeys, zebras, hyenas, deers, jaguars, and tigers. A particular highlight for kids is the underground reptile complex, which houses a variety of snakes, including the deadly king cobra. And now we are here in the next destinations. Welcome to the National Craft Museum. The Crafts of Museum, officially named the National Handicrafts and the Handlooms Museum, New Delhi displays a wide variety of traditional crafts from across India. Among its many fascinating features is the chance to watch highly skilled craftspeople demonstrated their centuries-old skills, as well as see large collections of textiles, woodworks, and ceramics. Also of interest are architectural displays of various regional villages, regional including the authentic mud huts and a full-size wooden haveli, a form of mansion house from Gujarat decorated with traditional folk arts and featuring exquisite wood carving, paintings, paper mache, and embroidery. And now we are here in the next destinations. Welcome to the National Museum Run! Spread across 10 acres, the National Rail Museum houses more than 30 locomotives and several old carriages, most of them quite rare. All told, more than 140 years of Indian railway history has been preserved on these fascinating sites, including an engine built in 1885 and the Fairy Queen steam engine from 1855. Other highlights include several unique items such as a collection of saloon cars belonging to the country's once powerful Maharajas, including the teak of carriage of the Maharaja of Mysore, covered with ivory, the cabin of the Prince of the Wheels from 1876, and the carriage in which the ashes of Gandhi were carried after his assassination of 1948, the skull of an elephant struck by mail train in 1894 is also displayed. And now we are here in our next destinations, the House Khaza complex is a fascinating urban village a little south of New Delhi. In addition to its numerous ancient stone monuments, the entire village is dotted with dom tombs of minor Muslim royalty who were literates from the 14th to 16th century. Other highlights include the remnants of an ancient college and the tomb of Firuz Shah, who ruled Delhi in the 14th century, as well as Qibla Masjid, a fine mosque built in Lodi styles. Be sure to allow extra time to explore the surroundings. The neighborhood, this bustling area, is safe and popular for locals and tourists alike for its arts galleries, fashionable restaurants, and boutique shops. As we are here in our last destinations, the Lakshminarayana Temple. If you're able to squeeze just one more temple into your Delhi sightseeing itinerary, make it Lakshminarayan. Temple Birla Mandir. It's also one of the newest such sites in the city. This impressive-looking Hindu places of worship was opened by Mahatma Gandhi in 1939 in Connaught Place as a dedication to the goddess of prosperity. Lakshmi shrines dedicated to other faiths are also included on the site, a condition stipulated by Gandhi. Spread across nearly 8 acres, the grounds are a delight to explore and features lush tropical gardens, fountains, and sculptures. Again, on behalf of Travel on Tours, we are very thankful for choosing us to become a part of your unforgettable trip here in the country of New Delhi. I'm looking forward for your next visit. Once again, I am Glynis Pitugo, your tour guide. Thank you and God bless. And have a nice day.